Alright guys, final part of, I'm going to say, the biggest match of my life. Playing against Brett Coletta. I'm just going to give you guys a quick rundown, in case you haven't heard in the last videos about who I'm playing. Brett Coletta, 19 years old, Golf Australia national team member. He finished medalist at the 2015 U.S. Amateur Championship. So he finished first out in the stroke play, beating the whole entire field. Very good players in it. Bryson DeChambeau, Ryan Ruffles, just to name a couple, but a lot of very good players. So he's not your average player. So he is a very good player, and I knew I was up for a challenge for this whole entire round. But guys got to bear in mind that I am still just 14 years old. And I'm playing against this guy. So obviously I wasn't, when I came into the tournament, I wasn't expecting to win. You gotta take it step by step. You know, first you gotta get into the match play. So I got into the match play. Now my next goal is to make it through round of 32. So to hopefully beat Brett, then it's to, you know, make it every step by step. So, alright, this is, the first match that I got to deal with, but we joined me on the 14th hole here. You guys are probably gonna wonder what I'm thinking. One down with five to play, par five. I was thinking on the tee box, you know, I made a good save on the last hole for par to keep it at one down. But on this hole, I was thinking, you know, if I can get a good driveway, hit it on the green, two putt for birdie, that'll give me a very good chance of bringing the match to all square. Then that puts me in a very good position coming into 15, which is a very tough par 4 into the wind. And then you got the stretch coming down, anything can happen, you know? But I really wanted to get that match to all square, so I was really hoping to birdie the next hole. Alright, this drive.
Yeah.
Just start up the right with a draw, hit it over those bunkers. That would have left me in a prime position to attack the pin.
Yep.
Yep, there's my ball rolling. Straight down the middle of the fairway, exactly where I wanted to hit it. It's probably 320. Red hit is down the left side, probably 350. He hits a long ball. This one, if you rolled over the back of the green, it would have rolled all the way down. It wouldn't have rolled into the water, but it would have been an impossible up and down if you do go long. So I want to err on the side of being short. It leaves me an easy up and down to the pin. Definitely being shorter, obviously, on the green would have been better. There, it's just short of the bunker, you can see. But pretty straightforward chip shot up to the pin. I think got a 54 in hand. Just trying to land it around halfway, maybe just a little further than that. And see if it'll release to the pin. And that would have given me a good chance. Brett had about 35 to 40 feet for his eagle opportunity. But, yep, maybe landed a little shorter than halfway, but still 2-3 feet to the flag, or to the hole. This putt is to, birdie it. Brett had already missed his birdie putt, so this putt was to win the hole, and hopefully I can get the match to all square. As you can see there, right after I putted it, I knew it was, going left. I just didn't get my starting point right. I started in the center of the cup. And it broke a little more, and also had a pretty bad stroke in it. But here, you can see the trees, the wind was coming straight off the right, and I pulled driver, just trying to start it up the right side and let the wind kind of take it. Maybe hold it off with a little baby fade, but didn't really do that. Rolled into that left bunker you can see there, and I'll just sort of explain something a little bit right now.
So this stage, there are 14 holes in my match, I'm one down. On the 15th hole, here, hit my drive in the left trap. Usually when I hit it in a bunker, fairway, or greenside, I expect to get out of it. Now it's hard enough, as it is, playing one of the best amateurs in the world. But for this to happen, in this bunker, for this level of tournament, and with all the players that went in it, I can imagine a lot of players went into that bunker. And I'm just shocked the caddies or players didn't rake up for them after they hit, and just happened to be that my ball went into a hole I'm not sure if it was a footprint because it rained, so it was very hard to tell where the footprints were, but it was just a hole. And as you can see in this clip, it's pretty bad. So I knew I was going to take bogey, and I was just hoping to either have the hole, but I wasn't expecting to win it, but to just try my hardest to have the hole, but I knew I was probably going to take a loss, and that was really going to put me down in the match, two down with three to play. So bit of an unlucky break, you can say, but I probably shouldn't have been to the bunker in the first place.
That's despicable. What sort of hole would do that?
So as you can see there, my ball is in a pretty deep hole. And actually, when you zoom out on this, it actually doesn't look as bad as it was. As you see there, it just looks like a normal lie and all, until you actually get in there and you see what a mess it is. So I had to punch it out with a 60 and just try to advance it 50, 60 yards up the fairway, leave me with a reasonable yardage to maybe make par at best. This was a 7-iron, I was trying to hit a baby cut and hold it off into the wind, but it kind of just stayed straight. I guess my alignment was a little too far left for that, but I was basically a little further than Brett with that putt. And here, trying to make it, you know, for something. If you make it, Brett was the same distance that I, best I could have hoped for was a half on the hole. So let's see if I can pull this putt off. I thought I hit a pretty good putt here. I just got the line a little bit incorrect, and he two putted, so I went to a two down with three holes to play. Full drive on this hole. It's very short, but driver was the best club in my bag on this day. A little rusty at the beginning of the round, but later in the round it was a pretty good club. It just rolled up there, as you can see, onto a cut lie. So this lie here, a very severe ball below my feet lie, tends to bring a cut into play. Winds were gusting, very tough. Actually, no, it wasn't. It was a very good pin for the lie I had. If it was at the left part of the green, it would have been very tough. But thankfully, it was at the right side of the green and back. Hit a 54, 110 yards out. I was starting in the middle of the green, letting the slope kind of bring it back to the pin. Can't see the ball. You can see where it lands here, but I still have this putt. It started raining a lot at this point during the round, as you can see there. But that was just an atrocious putt. That's kind of what my putting was like in the first round. But took the half on the hole. So that put me two down with two to play, which in match play is called dorming. So very tough position, not the ideal position you want to be in. So I knew I had to go birdie to close, or maybe par the last hole if I birdied this one. But I put this one a little right, just didn't draw back. Thankfully, you can see it rolling all the way up there. Thankfully, it didn't go in the hazard. I was still in the hazard, but I was able to find the ball. It was buried, awful lie. But I just had to pack it out there and see if I could hit on the green. I think I had 120 yards. I was hitting at 52. And just trying to hack it out. Rough kind of just turned the face over. And as you can see there, just left of the bunker. Very tough up and down.
So I'm there for two, and I need to birdie to still have a chance of being able to have the match. And the best I could do was take it to extra holes. But Brett was, you can see his ball. His ball was 15 feet for birdie, and he wasn't gonna three putt. Let's just put it that. So I knew I had to hold this chip shot, but something happened. When you're trying to win, and you have a shot to win, there's so much focus, that basically, I know it's easy to say, oh yeah, you should do that on every shot, but you just can't. You're not put in a situation on every shot, oh, this shot is to win. It's so totally different to when you actually have to win. I don't know if you guys have seen previous tournaments of mine, but usually when there's a shot that I need to hit under pressure, I kind of just hit the shot of my life most of the time. And I almost did it here, to be honest. You'll see the chip shot. If this was during the actual tournament, I wouldn't have tried to flop it. I would have just gone 10 feet past the hole and taken my par or at worst bogey. But here I tried to flop it, but in the same time put spit on the ball. It's a very it's a very high shot over the bunker, straight down a hill to that pin, knowing you have to birdie or make it. So a lot of pressure, but it's just something that takes tournament experience to be put in the position where you have to win, or you have to hit the shot to win the tournament. This wasn't really a shot to win the tournament, it was a shot to stay alive and to also give me a chance of winning the match. So you guys just keep watching and listening to me talk about the chip shot. I just explained about the pressure. This flop with spin straight down a hill, I mean, these greens are not slow. That was a pretty good shot under the circumstances. But I knew I was gonna lose the match after the ball didn't go in the hole. So I just wanted to not concede him that putt, just to give him the feeling of, oh, at least, I just didn't want to hear it, because you never know, something crazy might happen, but... Just finished my first round of match play, as some people call it a round of 64. Unfortunately, I lost 2-1 to a national team member, Brett Coletta. Played very well, and it was very tough conditions, and you can probably see the flags behind me. They're blowing pretty strong, and it was pretty tough out there, but I was able to hold it together for most of my round. I got off to a bad start. I was 2 down through 4, but kept it didn't go more than 2 down, so I was happy to do that. But I'd also like to thank Hunting Scratch Golf for filming the round today. My dad was caddying for me, as you'll see. He was on the bag, helped me a lot yesterday and today. But I'd like to thank him for being able to film and just coming out and watching me every round. But don't know when my next tournament is, but hopefully it's soon. So hopefully you guys can see more video of me playing. And I also hope you guys enjoyed the video of this tournament. See you guys soon.